Hello everyone, thank you for tuning in to Simple Crochet with Londa. Today I have this really pretty cluster stitch and it just makes this beautiful, beautiful fabric here. It can be used for any project. You can use it with any type of yarn and it's great for beginners. So let's get started. Begin this pattern of cluster stitch, you will be doing an even number of chains. So you can just do your chains and you can pause the video at this time. This sample swatch, I have done 20 chains. So if you'd like to follow along with the 20 chains. So we will begin by doing a single crochet in the second chain from the hook. One, two. Insert your hook into that second chain, and that is a single crochet. We'll do another single crochet in the next chain. So that's two single crochets. Now we will chain one, and then you will skip a chain and do another single crochet in the next chain. Chain one. Skip a chain, another single crochet, and chain one, and do that all the way across to the end of the row. You'll have three chains left. You will skip a chain, and you will do two single crochets in the last two stitches. So, so you'll have two single crochets in the last two stitches there, and we began with two single crochets at the beginning. Okay, now you will chain four, and you will turn your work. Now we will skip the two single crochets here, and now you want to reach over to that chain one space. And you will do yarn over. We're going to make our cluster now into that chain one space. Bring up a loop, yarn over, and go through two loops, leaving two loops on your hook. Yarn over, go into that same chain one space, drop a loop, yarn over, go through two loops. Now you have three loops. Yarn over, into that same space, yarn over, go through two loops until you have four loops on your hook. Yarn over, into the same space, yarn over, go through two loops until you have five loops on your hook, yarn over, and go through all five, and then chain one. So that is our first cluster. Now you've finished doing that chain one. Now you're going to jump over to the next chain one space and repeat the cluster. So yarn over, insert your hook, draw up your loop, yarn over, go through two loops. So you have two loops left on the hook. Yarn over, bring up another loop, go through two loops, leaving three loops on your hook. Yarn over, go through two more loops. You have four loops. And now one last time until you have five loops on your hook. And then you will go through all five and chain one. And that is your clusters. So after you chain one, you will repeat the clusters in every chain one space and until we're at the end of the row, and I'll meet you right there. You've completed your last cluster in this row two and you chained one. You should have two stitches left. You will skip this stitch and do a double crochet in the last stitch. So again, you end with a double crochet and then your turning chain counts as a double crochet. So that should be the same. Now you'll chain one and turn your work. Now we will do a row of single crochets. You will start with a single crochet in this first stitch right below that chain one. You will do another single crochet in this space right there. So you'll insert your hook in the space and do a single crochet. So you'll have those two single crochets. Now you will chain one, and you will now do a single crochet between the two clusters of the previous row in this space. So you will go right in this space and do a single crochet. Chain one, and again, a single crochet in that space. Chain one, and you will complete this all the way across. It looks like I'm gonna get right there really fast. So now you're at the end of this row and you have this space right here. So you will do a single crochet after you do a chain one. So you do the single crochet in that space, chain one, then in this space, you will do a single crochet, and then you will do another single crochet at the top of that turning chain. And there you go. And that's the end of this row for the clusters. Now we will chain four. I'm sorry. One, two, three, four, and then you will turn your work. Now you will do your clusters again by doing right in this space right here. So you have your two single crochets, and now you will do your cluster in that chain one space. Here's your single crochet, and then here's your chain one space right there between the two single crochets. You will do yarn over, go into that chain one space, drop a loop, yarn over, go through two. Yarn over, insert your hook in the same space, drop a loop, yarn over, go through two. Yarn over, go in there, pull up a loop, yarn over, go through two, you have four, and once more until you have five loops, and then yarn over and go through all five loops and chain one. And then you would just jump over to the next chain one space. So here's your two single crochets, and there's that chain one space, and you're going right into that chain one space to complete your clusters. And let me finish this off to end this row, and I'll end in chain one. You're at the end of the cluster row, and you will chain one, you will skip a stitch and do a double crochet in that turning chain to end the row. And that is the completion of our tutorial of the cluster stitch. This pattern is really, really pretty. Can be used with any type of yarn and hook size with that yarn. And it's kind of dense, so it would make a beautiful blanket, but can be used for any type of project you might have. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial today, a simple one, hopefully, and if you enjoyed it, please like, please share, and if you're a new viewer, please subscribe to Simply Crochet. Thank you, and have a great day. Bye-bye.